We'll try to share it to you guys. So, oh, before we go further, this slide, we try to go a little bit details about the solar energy. Okay, some of the slide might be redundant due to the overlapping of the information. We just take it as a recap or just to give us the reminder related to the previous parts. Okay, so some of the part might be lengthy due to the explanation. So I think perhaps you can try to discover by your own by referring to the main topic related to the area that Sir tried to share with you guys. Okay. So actually the best way to deliver this session normally during the face-to-face session. So we'll bring the student to my lab, my laboratory. Because in my laboratory you can have and you can see or you can touch or you can play around with the available photovoltaic module and also other components, let's say inverter, controller, the diameter of the wiring device, and etc. But this time around, unfortunately, we just only go for the slide. But from time to time, so we'll share the work that have been done in my lab so that you can have a better experience or better exposure related to the things specifically in solar technology. Okay. So, okay. So, all of the session, our view of solar power, how PV works, how PV cells are made. Okay. So, it's the thing. Efficient, efficiency, economic, cost, trend, and research. Maybe some of the parts in the outline we will skip. You may refer to the any resource of YouTube or video that you can refer with. Just go for a very crucial information related to the maybe perhaps on the efficiency of the PV, the type of the PV, how is work, how is facility or equipment needed to produce or to develop the solar power. Okay, so this is the sun. Okay. And then from the sun, attack to the earth, the sun ray, the sun ray attack to earth. And so this is the, I would say the tabulated intensity that certain country or state experience by having the sun ray throughout a year or throughout the surface of the earth. Okay, so the lighter means that less intensity. Okay, so it's much lighter, but the darker refer to the high intensity of the sun ray. So normally where is the darker or more to the reddish color means that it's a high available sun ray to be used as a part of the energy resource. Okay. So basically this is the sun attack to the earth, I would say attack lah. But the visible that we can see now is the range of this visible light. Okay, we have the infrared and the ultraviolet. Of course, they have their own wavelength. Okay, so this is the wavelength. Okay. So this is the our visible wavelength. So beyond that, the ultraviolet is a smaller wavelength. And the infrared also greater wavelength. Okay, so the energy, photon energy also depends on the visible light. Okay, basically this is the principle of the photon energy. Okay, so this the light and photoelectric effect. Okay, certain semiconductor material absorb certain wavelength. Okay, so this is a very clear statement. The shorter wavelength, the greater energy. Ultraviolet light has more energy. Ultraviolet means that the our left hand side just now. We'll try to recap this one. Okay, ultraviolet, our left hand side, which is smaller photo energy and also, sorry, smaller wavelength but high photon energy. Okay, for our right hand side, infrared, which is smaller wavelength but high photon energy. Okay. Shorter wavelength, okay, wavelength is the right hand side, okay, wavelength, sorry, shorter left hand side, sorry, left hand side. Ultraviolet has the more energy than infrared light, okay, alright. So, crystal silicon, visible spectrum, okay, crystalline silicon, plus some infrared radiation. Infrared is our right hand side. Heat versus electrical energy. So, this is the most thing that people confuse about the heat and electric energy. Light frequency that is too high or low for semiconductor to absorb them into heat energy instead of electric energy. Okay, so we need to consider the mechanism of the solar energy, because when we talk about the solar energy, it will produce us two form source of energy, either in the form of the heat from the solar energy or in the form of the light from the solar energy. So we need to differentiate this one clearly, because it will give you a different result. Okay, so what are the solar cell? Okay, solar cell is a thin wafer of the silicon. Okay, so if you can see the solar cell, let's say we go in the shop and we buy the PV module. Okay, so PV module, okay. PV module, and then the wafer refer to the only this question, okay, and this question, wafer silicon cell, to represent this shape. So only this one, only this one, only one cell. Much bigger, much cheaper. Okay, the bigger the cheaper, similar to the computer chip. Okay, silicon is abundant. Silicon originally from the sand, okay, sand, sea sand, okay. Not toxic, safe, okay. Let's carry into cell, okay. Cell convert sunlight energy into electrical, okay. Bear in your mind, the solar cell convert sunlight, not the heat, to energy to become the electrical current. Do not store energy, okay. They just convert. Sunlight is the fuel. Sunlight seems like the fuel. This silicon cell is the device that convert from the sunlight to the energy, electrical energy. Okay, we don't store energy. Okay. So this is the detail. Okay, so this is the detail of the. So when photon is from the sunlight, or photon, okay, attacks the n-type. Remember your physics, the n-type and the p-type lamination for semiconductor. Okay, when they attack this one, they will break the combination of the p-type and the n-type, and then they tend to go for the negative outward to here and positive outward to the back contact. Okay, so they will isolate the positive will go underneath the this one, and the negative will go upward this one, and then the movement for each electron will circulate, okay, and create the electricity. And since all the situation continuous running, so our light keep on lighting. Or else if the no sunlight, meaning there's no any photon to be break into the positive and negative, so that there's no any flow, I would say the flow from the negative also, because this one is the accumulated of the positive charge, and this one is the accumulated of the negative charge, and negative tend to go for the positive, and the circulation will be continuous running to produce the electricity. Okay, that's the basic concept, how it's work related to the PV cells. But normally, this part will be covered to the person who in charge related to the material and also the chemical and physics. Okay. So I think I will try to go this part quite fast, okay? Because there's a lot of video or the resource from the internet you can refer with related to the construction of the solar cell. Okay, now we try to go in the range of very basic. Okay, so this is the, I would say, the basic ingredient. So why we claim that the solar is a part of the resource that abundant, because we can get to produce this wafer from the sand, which is we have the free sand, okay, throughout the world. So you can get the sand and go some of the treatment or the processes by combining or dissolve or everything by having this kind of procedure, okay, and yet you get the end product, which is the in the form of wafer, okay, ingot, wasted ingot, or formation of ingot. Okay, so you have the free resource of sand, you have also the free resource of the sun ray. So meaning that you promoting a good exercise by using the free and abundant resource from the environment. Okay, so arc furnace, okay, dissolve the HCl, acid hydrochloric, distillation, okay, high quality commercial line, okay, reduction of with hydrogen, at degree C, and then go for the Swarovski process, okay, to become this kind of silicon crystal, and then cutting to a diamond sawing and become the silicon wafer. So that's the basic thing. But I want to try to highlight the main resource is from the sun, from the sand, which is we claim is a part of the abundant resource, which is from the environment. So this is the Swarovski process, which is this one. Yeah. Okay, silicon charm, molten silicon, and silicon ingot also. This is the thing that I mentioned just now, ingot. Okay, ingot. So seed crystal, put inside here, and molten silicon. And then become the silicon ingot. Like you produce the ice cream, okay? Ice cream batang, a stick ice cream, a stick ice cream. Okay, so this is the liquid, okay? And put your stick, the wooden stick, and freeze it. But this one is you need to go for the dedicated process, and yet you have a holder for the silicon ingot. Okay, so that's the how it look like. Drawing a silicon ingot. So that's the stick. Okay, stick. Okay, so this is the silicon ingot and wafer, which is this one is the ingot. This part is ingot in a form of shape, a cylinder shape with a various diameter. And then where you chunk or put the slices of each one, this ingot, they become the wafer. So this slice, circular size, this one, we call wafer. Okay. Wafer. So out of the material to produce the solar. Okay, so I think this is the continuity from the previous one. After they obtain the wafer, just go for, they say this is the wafer. And then they go for the chemical and mechanical polishing everything, okay, polish everything, doing the doping. Okay, doping. Remember doping? Doping for the N and P junction, PN junction, positive and negative junction, semiconductor properties. So that's the, you need to check back what's the doping and the power of the PN junction. And then it's just the method of the layer that we try to impose on the solar cell to ensure that the semiconductor attribute or the properties or the behavior of the semiconductor can be happened wisely in the form of the semiconductor. Okay. You guys still remember a semiconductor in your tables in a group of what? Number what? Number what of the property table? Do you remember? During your SPM examination? During your SPM? Silicon? In which group? For those who are taking the chemistry, should know. Okay. For those who are taking the physics, should know what is the PN junction. Or NP junction, or P junction, or N junction. Doping, the definition of the doping. Okay, it's okay, no problem. You may check for your own reference afterward, no problem. Just to mention that you should be know at least the basic, what's the meaning of the doping, what's the meaning of the form of P or N junction, okay? Okay, and then go for the anti-reflection coating, because what? Because we don't want the light that attack to the wafer will be going back, backward, reflect. So that's why we put some of the additive there to ensure that it can be received as much as the wafer can for the light part. The formation of the front contact, okay? Anti-reflection coating, and then interconnection testing encapsulate assembly module, meaning that so this is the wafer one, let's say wafer two, wafer three, the combination of the solar cell of wafer become the module, okay, become the module, okay. So that's the meaning of the things, meaning that from the solar cell or square shape or the round shape, the combination of this become the PV module, okay, PV module. In this case, I will put it square shape. Square shape. Struggle to draw this one. Okay, and then, okay. So this one is solar cell. Solar cell. This one is a module. Okay. So the combination of the module with the multiple module, okay, so become the array. Let's say this on one module, two module, three module, four module, four times two, eight module. That eight module, one module become array. Array, okay. Okay, array, array. This one array. Array. This one is array. So, guys, after this, let's say mentioned about the cell, you know, cell is only one unit of the solar module, okay. But if I say solar module, you know the solar module is the combination of the solar cell. But after this, after let's say mentioned about the solar array, meaning that's in the combination of the multiple module, okay. Okay, so we will try to practice that kind of term, okay, to make you guys familiar with the standard term of the solar PV or solar cell, okay, or solar energy as well. So, and then after they complete on the array, they will expose to the sunlight, okay, and then go for the testing to obtain maybe the voltage, the current, and etc. Okay, so that's the basic related to the solar cell producing until the solar array. Okay, so this is the sample of the computer chip on wafer, silicon solar cell in a square shape. Okay, picture of the PV cell. Okay, cell photovoltaic is the building block of the PV module. Okay, like I mentioned just now, cell, basic photovoltaic device, that building block of the PV model. Okay, so that's the thing. We still have efficiency approaching 31%. Solar module and array, like the mentioned just now. Solar module and array. Okay, so remember that summation that the solar cell, combination of the solar cell become the module, the combination of the module become the array. Okay, so we just keep this off. Okay, module, okay, array first. Okay, for now, guys, for now, the array about 5 to $6 per watt, 8 watt. And now we can have $1 per watt. Okay, $1 per watt. So it becomes more cheaper due to the abundance of manufacturer and also the needs from entire world. Maybe they try to compete in terms of the cost. So now we can get $1 for per watt. Okay, but I'm not sure whether we manage to get equivalent to the ringgit per watt. I'm not sure, but $1 per watt is confirmed. It's already in the market. Okay. I will try to check whether for an up to the 2020 is still available for the ringgit per watt. Okay. Connect to the solar cell to make module. Okay. Okay. So this is the basic idea. How is work related to the cell, solar cell? They say they check the solar cell produce 0.5 volt, and then they go connect the solar cell. Together have enough voltage to charge 12 volt battery and run pump and motor. Okay, in other words, let's say we go for this kind of condition. Let's say, so let's say when they check this one, let's say it produce you, let's say 0.5 volt. Okay, so let's say you want to produce this one is the, let's say 12 volt. Okay, 12 volt, let's say. So we need to combine this cell either in series or parallel to get this 12 volt. Okay, so that's the idea. So that's why in the combination of the several number of cells to become the module. Okay, so normally they will go for 12 volt or 24 volt or randomly 6 volt. So this range, normally in this range. For the PV. Okay. Okay. Okay, so connect module together to get any power configuration. Okay, so that's the thing. Okay, this is the definition of the PV module. It's the combination of the solar cell to become the PV module. So if you can see from here, there is two type of PV module, which is this one is the bluish color. This one more or less like the darker. So normally the bluish, we can trigger the type due to the polycrystalline type, but the dark one or more into the black color, normally they call the single crystalline or monocrystalline. So basically in the form of the silicon base of photovoltaic, we have two types of the photovoltaic, which is the monocrystalline or single crystalline, monocrystalline, and the polycrystalline or PC. The PS polycrystalline and monocrystalline. PV module have efficiency approaching 70%. So meaning that if you still remember from the solar cell, quite high. Okay, 21, but after they combine to become the module, slightly reduce to 70%. Okay. So compared to this part, so the monoxide will produce you higher efficiency compared to the polyoxide. So don't surprise, let's say with the same size and the same power, the polycrystalline will cost you higher compared to the monoxide will cost you higher compared to the polycrystalline due to the efficiency of the module. Okay, so this is the activity installation in a form of array. Okay, the combination of the module top array. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. on the rooftop. So this is one of the sample related to the module. Okay, the installation on the roof. Okay, also the stand up mounted array. Okay, so rack and pole mounted array. Rack means that previously we see the PV installed on the roof. So rack means that we create the from the land area, that we create the mimic like the rack, and then we install the PV. And this one seems like it tilting, I mean the slanting of the array refer to the, it might be perhaps this device have the tracking to track the sun ray. So that's why they chase whichever the highest intensity of the sun ray to be turned to get the maximum irradiance, okay, or intensity of the sunlight. Okay, kalau bukan aperture cover, so some of the user put as a patio or maybe dia tapak to install the PV array. So application to the space, okay, mask cover, but I think this one is too much lah, too much lah, spacecraft, and so you can go not until this far lah. You can go the solar module or PV array just behind our house lah, okay, just install to our rooftop lah. So this one is seems like some high end technology, right? But then actually it's just a matter of the producing the energy from the sun ray, you know, to power the Mars rover. It's too much, right? Okay, recreational use. Okay, so this one, so maybe you can use this one. Okay, discover remote area. Okay, remote area means that that area maybe cannot access the grid from the government electrical provider, so they try to install it in the rural or remote area so that they manage to get the electricity as well. Okay, on the residential or our house, we can place to install the solar PV. Okay, the commercial, okay, commercial building, they try to install this one first as a part of the roofing area as well. Okay, so in terms of the solar cell efficiency, so typically the solar with the crystalline properties in the range of 6 to 30%, but in general the monocrystalline will produce higher compared to the polycrystalline of the efficiency. Okay, and amorphous. Okay, maybe I forget to this amorphous. Okay, so the amorphous refer to the PV that can be, I would say, bending. Okay, for this crystalline, for the crystalline, we cannot bend the PV. It's a rigid structure. But for the amorphous, we can bend the PV. Normally, it will give you the more aesthetical view Okay, maybe some of our customer want to make the PV as a part of the decoration or more aesthetical approach. So we tend to buy the armor first, which is more flexible to be bent, to follow the curve and everything. But the compensation of the advantages, it only produce low efficiency. So yet again, if you want to have a better look, but you face the low efficiency, but you go for the very conventional design of the PV in the form of the crystalline, you can go for the up to the 20 to 30%, depends on the type of the PV. Okay, that's the typical power, 120 watt per meter square. So I think I'll just keep this one, okay, because this on depends on the location. There's several factors that affect for the efficiency. Okay, efficiency. Okay, which is we try to discover after that. I think this one is just the trend throughout the world. What is the PV? Okay, so we can see that the manufacturer and everything. Okay, we see peak hour. Everything. So this is the manufacturer and location, description. Yeah. So just skip this one. World solar power production. Okay, so the country. So they also mention this one in a form of this term of grid and grid connected. Okay, of grid meaning that with the battery grid connected, connect to the grid from the electrical provider at that particular country. Okay, so US is the highest consumer. 175. Okay. So the Japan. Okay. So cell production volume. Okay, so this one is just to give you the idea, the tremendous volume being produced over the years, which is refer to the good future implementation of the solar energy. By having the abundance of the production volume, is that the price will be more competitive, which is affordable to the consumer or the public to get or to have the device. Okay, so research, solar PV component. They have the inverter. The inverter is to convert the DC power to the AC, because normally in our house we use the electrical appliances in the form of AC, alternating current. Okay, so that's why we need the inverter to convert from the DC to the AC, because by default solar photovoltaic produce in the form of DC. Okay, and also battery also by default produce in the form of DC. So that's why we need the inverter to convert from the DC to the AC, because our appliances or to the AC form. Wiring is a very straightforward wiring. Okay, battery is the storage that keep your accessing energy from the solar to be stored and can be used during the night time. Okay, so maybe the daytime the solar will capture all the solar sun. The array will capture all your energy from the sun ray, and then it will store in the battery, and maybe some of the portion will be used to generate the load or electricity. But during the night time, when the sun is not available, so the battery will be used to power your load or electricity appliances during the night. For example, maybe your light bulb or something. Okay. Charge controller. Okay. Charge controller. I would say it's the brain of the system. For example, you have the module and also the battery. So the charge controller will divert all the energy that gained from the solar to the battery, and during the night time, by the signal from the charge controller, they will instruct the battery to power the load or electricity or electrical appliances. So I would say the charge controller is the brain communication from the all the devices in the solar setup. Okay. So which is we can control also the duration of the load. Let's say you want to install the light in your house during nighttime, and then you can set from the charge controller how long it takes to generate your light bulb. You can set, let's say, when the sun is not available, automatically the light will be on, and you can set how long the light can be on, either 2 hours, 3 hours, 15 hours, kind of. So in other words, you can set from the charge controller to give instruction how long your load can be last long for the dedicated setup. Okay, disconnect switches. I think for the safety issue. Okay, so for the safety issue, let's say you have all the arrangement, either OGPV or GCPV. So you can have switches just to protect your devices. Let's say when you install the things and suddenly rain, heavy rain, or the lightning strike to the roof, and then suddenly we attack your PV and we spike the current or voltage. So by having the disconnect switches, they will try to protect your devices of the OGPV or GCPV not to be damaged all over the connection. You will cut until the block of the switches. An electrical meter. Electrical meter measure electrical production. Okay, so this one is just to more into the monitoring. More into the monitoring. You want to monitor what is your PV power generated, and then by the daily basis perhaps, and then what is the your consumption of your electricity. So by having that kind of information, you can plan how to rearrange your utilization of your electricity bills. So system cost 8 watt. Okay, for the solar PV, for the OGPV, O off. Okay, for the OGPV, in terms of the kilowatt, normally for now, they go for, let's say, 600, sorry, 6,000 ringgit per 1 kilowatt, more or less. Meaning that, let's say you calculate your house need 5 kilowatt, so 5 times 6, 30,000, but for the GCPV slightly lower because the GCPV do not include the battery. It can go for 5 or 4,000 per I would say 5,000 or 4 to 5,000 kilowatt per kilowatt for GCPV. Okay, so you can estimate they say your house produce consume 2 or 3 kilowatt, 3 kilowatt time 5, 15,000 to get the free energy resource for the payback in the range of 5 to 6 years. But normally, how we can start to install when we reach the certain amount bill of electricity up to 100 ringgit, if I'm not mistaken, 1 or 200 ringgit, something like that, then it can still worth to install it. Any standalone PV system, I think we already discovered this one. Okay, click connected. Sorry, sound battery load. Okay. Just to recap this one. UV array, the neighbor array. Okay. Since the PV array in the form of DC, which is the AC load, this one is AC load, so DC, so we need to convert first to inverter, and then inverter already in the AC, okay, and then go to the distribution panel, okay, and then go to the AC. Okay, we have the one question from our friend. Sir, in our house is using AC? Yes, yes, Wong Chu Heng. Our house by default using the AC is our electrical appliances, which is received from the TNB. So that's why we need the inverter to convert from the DC to AC, because by default battery and the PV array give us in the form of DC. So that's why we need to inverter to convert. You can go for your DC without converting the using the inverter, but you need to change all your electrical loads, meaning that you try to buy the television, I mean, in the form of the DC, kan? Or your fan to the DC, kan? So that's the thing. Okay, won't you hear? Okay, good, thank you. Okay, so this is the thing. That's why, if you notice, as Sir mentioned just now, the OGPV give you more cost compared to the GCPV, because the OGPV or off-grid, they need this thing, battery, right? Because the GCPV, they do not need battery as a backup. The GCPV, they use the TNB grid as a backup. So, which is already embedded all the to the houses, for the things of the. But the good things of the OGPV, you can go for any rural area which is not available grid, wiring or grid connectivity. So that's the beauty of the system of the OGPV. So the, okay, so this is the grid connected, which are because no battery, right? No battery here. So grid connected, which is they will connect to the electric utilities, AC load, distribution panel. So from PV array, they need to convert as well, because PV in the form of the DC, convert to become the AC, and yet go to the AC for the loads, okay, distribution panel and electricity. Yeah. So it's a very straightforward. So in other words, so grid connected, will cost you lower cost due to the not available of the battery. Okay, so that is the one of the issue. But bear in your mind, this kind of RM5,000 per kilowatt on OGPV or GCPV just now that Sir mentioned is only dedicated to the device as for the devices as well. Only meaning that it compromise of the PV inverter, the battery and everything, that include the housing of the equipment. Okay, let's say for example, for OGPV, we need to buy the battery, right? But of course, we need to store or to put the battery some sort of the proper compartment or space area. So that compartment or space area do not cover, not include in the pricing that Sir mentioned just now. Okay. So that's totally only for the devices to be connected to be functional. It's not related to the thing, let's say for the sake of the space area that put all the devices, everything. Okay. So only for the things to be functional. Okay, so this is the PV to the grid. Okay. So it depends. Okay. So inverter always come with the either GCPV or OGPV, because it need to go for our outlet in our house in the form of the AC. Okay. And then some of the part go to the grid, okay, to be backup. Let's say during the daytime, they can use the solar, but during the nighttime, the grid will power the house. Okay, let me click. I think we just keep this one. So already explain this thing to you guys. Okay, so maybe this is the proper sentence to you understand. When your system produces more electricity than your home, okay, your system is that your PV, your PV system, or your maybe your GCPV system, GCPV. Okay, when your GCPV system produces more electricity than your home use, the system flow back to the grid. Okay, meter run backward. Okay, the meter run backward and get your credit to the electricity cell to the utility. So that's the net metering, how it goes and how it works. Okay, so the remaining power that you are producing will go back to the grid and offset the meter bill so that it will deduct your monthly use. So by having that kind of approach, you can save your monthly billing by contradict or opposite the meter of the charges. Okay, inverter basic, I think so it's also already mentioned just now. The DC to AC, okay, from here, power appliances, okay. So every inverter have their own dedicated specification, so we need to very careful in selecting which is the most suitable specification of the inverter, because we don't want to buy the things that oversize. Oversize means that they say your system need produce 1 kilowatt from the PV array, but you are buying the inverter for let's say 10 kilowatt, which is oversized. Yeah, it should be considerably should be matched between the PV array and also for the inverter to avoid any waste of money to be spent for the dedicated system. Okay, grid problem. Okay, so is the grid means that from the TNB side, okay, normal everything. Okay. What time now? 10:35. Okay, we break 3 minutes. 3 minutes long. 2 minutes. But then you can ask the any question. While we are break 2 minutes, so try to answer your question. Okay, sir. If the electricity flow back, so TNB will lose money because they cannot sell the electricity. No, not like that. Okay, so. If the electricity is flowback, so flowback means that your meter as well will be flowback. I'm not sure whether TNB will lose or not, because they will using the FIT fit in tariff, they need to give the money to the user, but this time around they just contradict the utilization of the power by contradict or backflow the power generation, meaning that in terms of the user or customer, for us we get the benefit because we produce the extra power, but we don't use all the power, we have the remaining power, and then we go to the grid. When we go or transfer to the grid to the TNB, our kilowatt meter will be offset as well, so that we only pay the less or very minimum a charge for that particular month. In term of the TNB, even they so-called running loss due to the no charge or money to be generated by receiving the power. But actually they do not lose as much as you expected, because what? They already have the power which they need to produce in a plant already covered by the user, by accumulated from the other user to be stored as a part of their standby energy resource. So in the form of money, yes, they do not have that money, but they can store your energy and avoid them to produce more because they already have the standby energy from the user or customer. Macam tu, Zaymi. Is that okay? So by yet, so yet actually, so for the TNB, let's say you give the TNB back energy 5 kilowatt, for example. Kan? For example, 5 kilowatt, you give the free energy to the TNB. So in other words, TNB get the 5 kilowatt without producing from the power plant. They got it directly from the customer. So they save the production to produce the 5 kilowatt energy just to compensate with your bills. Can compensate with your bills, which is you do not pay the accessing another 5 kilowatt, and at a certain time, TNB can save to produce another 5 kilowatt by storing your energy, your accessing energy. Maybe at the TNB, to produce the 5 kilowatt is quite high compared to receive your extra 5 kilowatt. So that's why they go for that way. Yes, correct. We supply, seems like we are support the TNB to donate to, it's not donate lah, to give them the accessing energy that we produce to be stored at the TNB. Macam tu, Nazirul. We supply the electricity and then they try to keep in their storage by hold the things, and maybe they will go to divert to other ni lah kan, other industry lah, which is higher tarif kan. Let's say kita domestic produce the accessing energy, we go for the reset for the net metering, and then that remaining energy that we store in the TNB facility. And then for the others who need the things, it's already in a standby mode instead of they need to produce another one. Okay. Let's say, just imagine one house, let's say give, let's say 5 kilowatt, let's say, for example. So 10 house, the 50 kilowatt. Okay. So they do not need to produce another 50 kilowatt, which is in a standby mode, lah, in a bank of the energy. Kind of, lah. Nazirul and Zul Hilmi. I hope it clarify the concern or the question. Ninja tak bagi serehat ya. Okay, sorry. Sampai apa tu? Tidak lagi. Okay, hold on. So what is the time now? 10:40. Okay, 10:40. So yeah, after this you got have a class or not? This one, after this. Okay. No class, okay. Very transparent. Good. Normally, if I ask during the class, face to face, if no class, also answer is yes, have class. But this online session, I think, a good way, student. Because I think during the online, seems like no class again. So every time is no class. Okay. Okay. G is already. Khaled, are you orang Khaled? Khalid. Ha? Khalid no class. Oh, Makrul. Oh, okay. Okay, yeah, so try to... Oh, Khalid, you are here. Yes. With the same hairstyle. Okay. Maybe we try to make the salon, or my hairstyle, like Khalid. Okay, I will try to check this slide first. Is that long or not? Because I want to give you guys the opportunity to ask any question related to the things. Wah, banyaknya. Quite. I think we cannot complete this one for this another 10 minutes. Wait, hold on. Okay, I will try my best. I will try my best. Okay. We try this. We just go another maybe 45 and another 10 minutes. Then we open the question, maybe another 5 minutes. And then, of course, a certain of the slide might be replicate from the others. So maybe we can skip that one first before we go for the towards the end of the session. Okay, guys, seating and designing. It's not seating, it's sizing. Okay, it takes some time due to the lot of notes. Okay, I'll try to open it back. Okay, sizing and designing solar PV. Okay, so the most important part, if you want to install your PV system, you need to identify your location. You can just imagine how important the location is. Repeated 3 times. Located 3 times. Located 3 times. Location, location, location. So means that is crucial to determine your location. So for Malaysia, our latitude is 4 degree north and 100, almost 101 east. Okay, meaning that for the horizontal, we are slightly upward from the equator, 4 degree north. And in terms of the longitude, which is the left hand side, we are towards for the right hand side, 100 east, 101 degree east. Okay, so of course, what about Sudan and Yaman? Do you have any idea what is the location, latitude and longitude for Yaman and Sudan? Khalid and Ji. I'm not sure. Adoi. Oh, Adoi means that what? In English, Adoi? Guys, Adoi. I will check. Adoi. Thank God. Thank God, boleh kah? Thank God. Macam syukur pula. What a fish. Boleh kah? I will check. Okay. Okay. Please check also. Khaled, okay, we check. Okay, while waiting for them to check, we try to go. So you need to check this one, Khaled and G, your latitude and longitude of your country, your one two. So that you can appreciate the condition to be installed of your solar PV at your country after you graduated as a mechanical engineering student. Okay, while waiting for them, okay, wait, latitude, lower latitude, higher latitude. Okay. So, weather, clear sunny sky better than cloudy sky. Of course, temperature not important. Directions all are phase array, absence of shades. Okay. So that's the requirement that you need to know for the installation. I think I will try to go for only this slide because it's crucial to you guys to know this thing. Because this is the key factor before you try to install all the things. Okay, I'll try to this one. Because what? When you know your location, you can have your idea. What is the, I would say the correct tilting or slanting of your PV module or array. Oh, gee, 15 north and 48 east. Okay, 12.8 north and 30 east. Okay, meaning that from this kind of information, G and Khalid, actually, Sudan and Yemen more or less at the close latitude area, which is in the horizontal line of the Earth. You are more or less at the same line of horizontal, and in terms of the vertical line. Vertical line of from the world, I mean the longitude. So you are slightly towards for Khalid or Sudan, more or less like the more left hand side compared to the Jian, which is Khalid 30 degree east, followed by the G 48, and followed by Malaysia 100. So we are meaning that. Sudan and Yemen not that far enough in terms of the longitude, and also in terms of the latitude, you are more or less the same, 12 and 15. Compared to the Malaysia, we are far beyond from you guys, which is 4 degrees north. Is that clear, everybody? So in other words, the condition of Khalid and GS to install the PV in terms of the slanting, in terms of the slanting and the T angle, should be different compared to the Malaysia slanting or T angle, because due to the geographical latitude. Okay, so that's the idea why we are doing this one. So, in other words, maybe G and Khaled can share the information. What is the suitable angle need to place your PV module, because you are more or less similar in the term of the latitude. Okay, thank you, G. And yeah, sorry, I Khaled. Okay, weather means that, of course, you need to assess that particular area, whether that particular area available for the very cloudy, which is your additional resistance. Compared to the direct sunlight you can obtain without the interference of the cloud and everything, which can affect your receiving amount of irradiance. Okay, and direction of solar array. Direction of solar array means that you need to be very careful to install your PV, because it should be always facing to the sunlight instead of facing backward from the sunlight. Okay, so the absence of the shade. Maybe I can show you by the meaning of the direction of solar array. I will try to stop this one. Direction of solar array. Stop this one. I will try to go for the video. Hello guys. Okay. Let's say this is your PV. This is your PV. Okay. In Malaysia, since we are nearby at the equator, so we tend to place our PV more or less horizontal like this. Okay. But for the country like Sudan and Yemen, since they are in the range of the 15 to 13 degree north. So they slightly need to turn the slanting more or less the 15 to 13 north facing the sun ray. Okay, so this one is the PV module. This is the sun ray. So this is the thing, because the maximum irradiance always goes for the perpendicular to the sun ray. Let's see Malaysia. Let's say this is the slanting. So this is the perpendicular. So for the For the Sudan and the Yemen, they say this is the latitude, so the perpendicular of the sunray should be like this. So we need to consider that one. It's a part of the consideration because we afraid that you put wrong side of the facing. They say the sunray is like here, so you do not have the knowledge of the tilting or latitude. You are placing this way. It's still tilting, but not facing the sunray, which is you cannot get the maximum irradiance or the intensity of the sunlight. Is that clear? Is that okay? Is that manageable? So the angle is referred to this one. This one. Sorry. This one. This one. This one. This the area. This the angle. Sorry. So this is the angle. They say 0, 90, 45. So this one is the angle of the PV model based on the horizontal area. Okay. So the difficulty is that the difficulty. Let's say in the class, then I can show you very straightforward. Okay, but it's okay. No problem. We'll stop the video. Stop the video. And then go to the sharing slide as well. Share slide. Okay, so that's the meaning of the direction of the solar array phase. So based on the information, your location, so you should be able to not have the wrongly place your PV, specifically facing which part. Okay? So because if you are going opposite way of the facing, it will cost you a very low irradiance, which is you should receive a maximum irradiance of the two. Absent of the shade means that, let's say you install the PV, please ensure your surrounding, there's not any building that block the sun ray to your PV model to receive the sun, the sun ray, because I would say, for now, let's say you try to install the thing, but in the future, maybe your surrounding, we develop another building or they plant the tree and block your PV module, and will cause you receive only a minimum solar irradiance. Okay. So, key factor location, how much resolution system, DC rating, okay. So, I think that's all for today. We are running out of time, so almost 11 o'clock. So maybe in the following class, we will try to proceed this part because this part is quite crucial and and important. By having this kind of knowledge, you can try to appreciate why you are looking outside. The PV is tilting certain angle, why certain PV installed by the surrounding of the tree and plant, they are not considering the shading effect and everything. So I think it's quite crucial to give you this kind of information so that you can become a student with a good real practice exercise related to the solar energy. Instead of you are knowing the knowledge, but in a practical wise, you cannot imagine or appreciate the real practice part. So by having the slow motion of this kind of session, I think we give you more understanding and can appreciate the utilization of the RE in a wise manner, accordingly with the theoretical and also the practical ones. So before we end the session, any question from you guys? Well, I will stop sharing first. Stop sharing. Okay, any question, guys, before we end the session? Exhausted. Straight 2 hours. Let's stop. Okay, so stop. I'll go for the chatting part. Okay. Clear. Okay. Any question, guys, before we end the session? So next following week, Thursday is a public holiday. So Friday we have a class. Friday is not public holiday. Public only Thursday. So Friday we still have the class. Okay. But next week, I think crucial part, maybe I will try to go for some of the calculation related. Normally, I will try to show this calculation through the whiteboard lah kan, whiteboard, but this time around I'm not sure whether I manage to teach you guys calculation via the online, but we try our best lah. We try our best. It's my first time to teach you guys for the sizing related to the PV, via Ulearn, via, I'm sorry, via online session. Okay guys, anything before we end the session? Thanks for your time, by the way. So hopefully, okay, just to share with you, so currently so have a project related to the installation designing of the solar system at school, at the school. Maybe from time to time, so we'll share you the video or short video lah, kan? So go for take by myself kan, or so request others to capture the video that I've been work with, so try to share in our group, so that if you want to ask or you want to more detail, maybe you can ask during the class session. The project related to the is the design, install, design and install. Okay, for now up to the, I would say 80% of completion. So it the combination of the solar PV, also the wind energy, and also the hydro energy. So we combine these three renewable energy resources in one system to educate our kids to appreciate and know fundamental knowledge about the renewable energy. So currently I'm working on that. So maybe from time to time we try to share the video or any things that I think can give you some sort of the exposure related to the project that have been conducted now. Okay, maybe in the future you want to go in detail related to the RE, renewable energy. So maybe you have a better exposure on that. Okay guys, if no question related to the today topics, so thank you very much. So thank you for your commitment and cooperation. So we will updating by time to time. So all the best and see you next following week with the more challenging parts. So far, what is the expectation? Is that more easier compared to the power plant, right? Okay, you may leave guys now. So just wait until we have, no, oh, those who have the question, you can wait until the end session, sister service. Wait until all of you left the group, left the session. Nabil, Basdi, salam Jumaat. Okay, doakan saya Nabil, Basdi. Doakan saya, doakan saya. Thank you, Doktor. Thank you, Jahe. Thank you, Meng Zian. Thank you, Meng Zian. Thank you, Doktor. Thank you. Should I welcome all? Welcome all. So sorry, for any not fluently address all the information. Welcome. Fatin Hanani. Welcome. Okay. Yeah, Willy Yun. Welcome. Thank you, Dr. Welcome, Fatih. Atika, thank you, welcome. You may call me Sir je, Atika. President, just call me Sir je. Do not need to call Doctor. Doctor is too powerful. Like very power. So, Sir, biasa-biasa. So, panggil Sir je. Welcome Hafizuddin. Sir level power sangat. Sorry, doktor. Doktor level power. Sir level biasa-biasa. Aiman, please stay back. Aiman ada tak? Aiman, ayo lah. Okay, so it doesn't matter. Aiman ada tak? Welcome. Okay.